Okay, that is the first actual automation I wanted to share with you. So the second one is publishing content on Autopilot. And from the survey, I already saw that you're way more experienced than maybe with the Facebook AdWords. And you can pitch in when you have good ideas and would like to add something, then I bring you the mic and I would love to hear your experience, yeah, based on that. So this is our posting schedule. We are trying to post 80 times per week across all of the poor girl who's doing this. Raise your hands, dear Christina. Hello. You see, it's a hard job. There are a lot of red areas where maybe it worked out, where it didn't work out. It's not bad. We are super happy with the amount of posts we're doing currently. Yeah, it's like in the 90s and 80s, which is really great. But of course, this is a lot of work. And as marketers, we kind of still love doing that because the tools that have been created are very, very imperfect. And we are super unhappy with Buffer at the moment. And we have really scaled down our automation of publishing because using the native features are just so much better. Scheduling a post on Facebook or LinkedIn natively just gives you a much more Facebooky feel, yeah, of the actual post. And the first step we did in order to actually automate it a little bit is to create a promotion template where every single step, every format we are posting over a single month is comprised into one monthly template. You can download this if you get the last content and storytelling meetup slide. Yeah, it's with the same link /busy. They will see on the right-hand side that you can download that as well if you want to get our promotion template. That was the first thing. We try to observe what are we doing very regularly and write that down as a first step. And then we started to look out for scheduling tools. There are a lot of tools like the native scheduling tool on the platform, and we always prefer that. For example, on Facebook, we hardly ever use Buffer because the Facebook group and page scheduling tools are good, but for the personal profile, it doesn't exist. So we first had to create like a checklist, where can we automate, where not? And then we tried a couple of tools, and I saw some in other project, and I would like you to pitch in if you want to, if you have an idea for a better one. So Buffer has been really good for scheduling. Yeah, just getting the post out at the right time, having a content pipeline, being able to push it out to several platforms. Hootsuite does the same, but it's also good with the whole monitoring part. You can set up like your channels where you can observe hashtags much easier than I could do in Buffer. Later and IconoSquare are pretty good with Instagram. They had some problems, at least later, that some Instagram accounts got banned for a while. Did any one of you have problems with banned Instagram accounts because you did auto-publishing? There was a phase there. I had like several clients where this actually happened. And with IconoSquare, we didn't have a problem. We were really surprised because both are actually officially supported by Instagram. Yeah, but those publishing platforms, they don't like automation as much as we do. So then there's a really clever one called Meet Edgar. What this does better than the other ones, you can give it like an evergreen content schedule. Let's say you give it 60 posts and it will always keep on republishing them over time. Imagine trying to remember what you posted 60 days ago. Not gonna happen, yeah? But what if you could put your best posts that you did that are evergreen in relevance, and you could just resurface them in a regular interval and have that managed by Meet Edgar? Yeah, I really like that idea in general because that is also part of the marketing automation, keeping what works going, not publishing something else next week again and next week again something else. Here we can. Here we have one that thinks about it in a little way, a little bit in that way. So then we have co-schedule, which actually gives you a really nice editorial calendar where you can see which post is going out in which channel. I also like that a lot. It's also good for WordPress publishing and articles. I would love to hear from you. We already heard some tools you have been using. So what is your favorite publishing tools tool in the past, and how have you been using it? Anybody? What was the one that you have been using? Can I ask you? Yeah. Yeah, can you tell me about Tailwind? What is it good? What is it not so good?
Tailwind, I am using it only basically for Pinterest.
Yeah, right, it's Pinterest. Yeah. Uh-huh.
And at the moment, Pinterest changed algorithms, and yeah. So it is telling you that it has like auto, everything is auto, so it's going to tell you when you're going over the limit.
Okay.
And also you can link your Facebook account, your Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
Yeah.
However, I have not tried for Facebook and for Instagram, because it's cluttering my Facebook, the Facebook page.
I'm curious, how's Pinterest working for you?
Really well. Really
what are good. You doing? Can you tell me? What's your business?
Business?
Yeah, whatever.
I'm a writer.
Yeah.
So I'm a writer. And so I'm
writing. What do you write about?
I write about personal development.
Yep.
Yeah, mental health.
Okay.
And so I'm using Tailwind to publish.
Okay. So you blog posting primarily, or doing graphic art?
I'm writing posts.
You're writing posts.
Yeah.
I'm
writing articles at the moment, and so yeah.
And how much traffic are you seeing from Pinterest?
From Pinterest, most of my traffic, like 100,000.
Per which time unit?
A month.
Per month. 100,000 visitors from web from Pinterest. I think this is super rare, right? Yeah, thank you for sharing that experience. Yeah, my brother and I, we used to have a drone website, and Pinterest worked there a little bit. Yeah, but not 100,000 per month. Really great. Anybody else who has a tool that they really like that I should know about that is not on this list? All right. Yeah, sure. Hit me with a question.
Any tool for marketing optimization for LinkedIn? Because I strictly target business to business.
Yep.
There is no business to customer journey in my business.
Okay.
And I only target businesses. Mm-hmm. And the number one, even though it's pretty expensive, ad platform is LinkedIn, I would say.
Yeah.
And therefore, any tips, advice, or whatever for LinkedIn
automation. So there are a lot of automation tools, keep it for a moment, that help you to connect with people, to send contact requests, like Leopold, like Linked Helper. Mm-hmm. Yeah, those are, for example, big ones where you can give people a search list of people, and then it will automatically connect those people. I'm not particularly endorsing that approach. Yeah, I prefer to go manual on LinkedIn, but you can do that. Mm-hmm. And there is a cool analytics tool for LinkedIn called Shield, shieldapp.io. I was surprised that is like the only profile monitoring tool. The other ones are focused on the page. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but Shield is really cheap. We are using it. Matti is in it as well. I am. And you can see the growth curve since we are hustling really strong. We now went like over 6K. And I think I reached the 5K like 2 or 3 weeks ago. Oh, okay. Yeah. And you can really see the progression there, which you usually can't. Any other recommendation for LinkedIn automation tools? There are not so many, I think.
That's why I'm
asking. Yeah.
Thank you.
All right. Please.
There is a great tool called Phantom Buster.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which is semi-legal and helps you to scrape LinkedIn profiles and allows you to do a bunch of other stuff. Try at your own risk,
yeah,
I'd say.
Yeah, it's totally try at your own risk. I didn't want to mention that one, but glad you did. All right, so this is what you do. So let's take just one example of how to do it on Buffer. This is how Buffer looks like. You have a list of all of your profiles on the left-hand side, and then you can say, I want to create a new post. Yeah, and this is how it looks like. You can decide by pressing on the buttons where it's supposed to be published. And let's say we want to publish it everywhere. Then you have certain limitations of how many characters you can use, how many images you can upload, or whether or not you can do videos. Videos in Buffer, not friends. And here I decided to write a little text, demo text with three pictures of it. And then when I press customize for each network, which I really appreciate, I can now use different hashtags on different platforms. I sometimes can tag people, sometimes not. If I'm in the publish and everything area, I can usually not tag anybody. But there are certain limitations that really bug me. For example, I can never tag events, and I'm an events guy. Why can I not tag events? I know that weirds me out. So I can customize for each platform, which I would highly recommend, especially if you have long form posts. Twitter will kill you. Yeah, like you have to put that into several tweets underneath each other. And if you want to learn more about that, we also got some resources set up for you. Buffer has a great section about how to automate your social media. It's very comprehensive. And of course, those platforms have a big incentive to show you. But I just put in some of the best. I put the Buffer in even twice. Yep. All right. So what I try to do on social media with automation, I try to automate in order to increase my consistency with posting. For example, where we still like to automate with Buffer is on the weekend. Yeah, we step down on the automation during the week in order to make a more native feeling experience for each platform. But on the weekend, I really prefer not to tell Christina, yeah, you have to get up and post for me. We still sometimes do it though. Yeah, I'm very thankful for that. It's especially when we try to post videos on the weekend, it always fails for whatever reason. Buffer creates, like on LinkedIn, a landing page, puts the video there, and then links the landing page in the post instead of just publishing the native video on LinkedIn. It's super weird. Yeah, so we are trying to be mindful of what kind of posts we can automate. What works best is images and text. Yeah, image and text posts are safe. Pretty much, but not in every format. For example, on Twitter. On Twitter, if we post through Buffer, it will always look 16:9, even if we post a square video. Yes, Twitter has been changing formats recently anyways, but that was just a weird thing that didn't happen when we published natively through Buffer, through Twitter. So let's automate when it's actually improving our consistency, but doesn't take away from the love and the messaging and your connection with your audience.